Hey guys, Mike Thurston here at Aurora Athletic, and I hope you've all recovered from yesterday's chest and shoulder workout. Today it's day three and we're going to go through back. So today we're literally trying to hit the back from every single angle possible. Now, because yesterday was chest and shoulders, we're pretty much working the anterior chain, so that'd be the front of your body. Today it's the back, it's the rear. We'll be hitting lats, mid back, lower back, and rear delts and traps to give that real sort of 3D thick big back. So starting off with the first exercise, we did wide grip pull-ups. Wide grip pull-ups is generally one of the more challenging exercises, so it's gonna require a hell of a lot of strength. And with the first set, I wouldn't go to complete failure, because if you do so, you know, you don't really have much left in the tank to do your second, third, and fourth set. So I'd go close to failure, but not completely failing. Rest, you probably need a little bit more recovery with this kind of exercise because it will be testing your strength. And you're doing 3 to 4 sets in total. It's going to depend, you know, some individuals will maybe only be able to get 5 to 6 reps out, others a little bit more. I'm aiming for the 8 to 10 rep range. Second exercise, we did a bent over barbell row. We're trying to work a lower down, lower trap, mid portion of the back. So what I do with the bench, I put it about 35 degrees, 40 degrees, so that it kind of takes my lower back out of the equation. It completely isolates the area I'm trying to work, and it just means that I'm not going to be swinging back and forward, and allows me to lift as heavy as I possibly can. So with the barbell row, again, we're going to go for strength, so I'd aim between 7, 8 to 9 reps, and we're going for 4 sets. The third exercise is a superset. We're doing heavy T-bar row, superset with it's like a lying dumbbell pullback. So with the T-bar row, torso not too far bent over, you're about 45 degrees or higher. And because you're pulling that bar towards you, we're trying to get a big squeeze in the mid area of the back. Again, full range of motion. So as you lower the bar down, you almost push your shoulders forward. Initiate movement by retracting your shoulders all the way back and then driving your elbows up. And then with the dumbbell pullback, I'm going to be lying down on a bench about 30 degrees. And again, I'm pushing my shoulders forward and then I'm pulling the dumbbells back as I push my chest out and holding temporarily at the top of the movement and then going back to the starting position. So with the T-bar row, we're going to go for 10 reps and the dumbbell pullback, 10 to 12 reps with 4 sets each. Exercise number 4 was the alternating cable pull down. So what I'll do is I'll sit my stool. I need 2 cables, the attachments at the top. And this one, not so much working on our strength. This is really just feeling the contractions in the lats. I'm gonna pull one down at a time, driving my elbow down and pinching my lats, squeezing as hard as I can. I'll put it back to the starting position. I won't completely relax. My lats will still be in the tension and I'll drive the other one down. So I'm gonna do one at a time. We'll be aiming for about 20 reps. It's important that as you pull it down, the angle of the cable is in line with your forearm. If you start to bring your hand towards you, you then in effect kind of do like a bicep curl, which is not what we're trying to achieve here. So ensure that as you drive the elbow down, the cable is in line with your forearm. The next exercise is kind of, I've combined the rack deadlift with a shrug. So when I do one rack deadlift at the top of the movement, I'm gonna do a shrug. Pull the bar up, squeeze my traps as much as possible, lower the bar back down, and then go back down into the next rack deadlift. So it's a rack, shrug, deadlift. This is gonna be working your entire back. It's very important when you do this that you almost, you know, you're holding your shoulders back the entire time and pushing your chest out, and you're almost doing like a lat spread. So hands wide, holding the lat spread, and you're basically leaning forward whilst keeping your shoulders retracted. And that's gonna make sure that your whole back is under tension and working. back to the cables. Again, not too heavy on this one. We're just trying to feel the squeeze and the contraction of the lats as much as possible. We'll have a stool. You're gonna have the attachment to the cable about probably just above hip height. And again, one arm at a time. The benefit of doing one arm at a time is it means we can get the greatest range of motion. Rest period is usually quite short on this one because as you're doing one arm at a time, your other arm is pretty much resting. So I'll do one, I'll go into the other, very short rest, and then straight in again. Finally, we're doing rear delt flies. Now this one, again, you'd think, well, why am I doing this on back day? Because I said at the beginning, I'm trying to focus on the entire posterior chain from the waist above. And it's really going to give you that 3D effect, which is what most people tend to struggle with, because most people have a very dominant front and medial delt. You can do these standing, but for what I'm doing quite high rep. So I'll be doing it on a bench, so I can kind of relax my lower back and really focus on what I'm trying to do. And I'm going to go for very high reps with this. It tends to be 20 to 30 reps. Sometimes it might be even more. Like, I'm going to be doing this until my rear delts are burning. This is probably one of the few exercises where you actually want to push your shoulders forward. If you're pushing your shoulders forward and almost making an arc with your hands, you want to try and make an arc as big as you can, and you're only going up halfway. So it's a partial rep. The reason behind this is it's just going to focus on the rear delt. If I'm to go any higher, then I start to retract my shoulders and I'll begin to engage my back. Thanks for checking out Back Day. Tomorrow is going to be arms.